Welcome to Food Fund, sponsored by From Scratch Kitchen and Better Homes and Gardens Real Estate Prairie View. I'm your host, Matt Dominguez. We're coming to you today from the From Scratch facilities located on 401 Victoria Avenue. So what we do is we take a recipe from the Better Homes and Gardens cookbook and we make it with a special guest. Today's guest will be cookbook author and cooking expert, Ms. CJ Katz. And we're gonna be making some cherry cooking bars on page 280, and some spritz cookies, which are on page 268. So let's meet our special guest today, CJ Katz.
Hey.
Hey, how's it going?
How are you
doing? I'm good.
Merry
good.
Merry Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas to you too.
Okay. Now I wanted to let you know that I had to wear one of these ugly Christmas sweaters.
Yes. Absolutely.
I love yours. A little tight there.
Little tight on me, but we're gonna work with it today.
But here's the thing. You made me wear this.
Yep.
My kids told me I looked like my grandmother, so I have something here for you.
Oh, is that right?
You have to wear.
Okay.
All right. It has to be equal, man.
All right. Okay. Well, let's do it.
So let's get going here, Matt. So, do you know how to bake? Do you do much baking?
The only baking I do revolves around eggs as well. So.
Oh, perfect. Okay. So what we need here is we need equal amounts of butter and shortening. You dump that in here.
All right.
So there's our shortening.
Shortening and the eggs, or sorry, shortening and the butter as well.
Yeah, half a cup of shortening, half a cup of butter. Okay. So we'll pop that in. So there we go. We're gonna clean this together we're gonna put in some sugar.
All right.
So there we go.
A full cup?
What you wanna do is we're gonna actually put in a cup and 3/4.
Oh, gotcha.
Now dump in the baking powder and the salt, and let's get that going. Okay, so now we're gonna add in our eggs one at a time.
Okay.
So let me do the first one there for you.
Okay.
And that is 3 cups of flour.
3 cups of flour.
Pop that in.
Oh, I guess it's already measured out then.
It's already measured.
Okay.
So there you go. And while we're at it, let's dump in a teaspoon of vanilla. We've got all of this together.
Okay.
We wanna use about half the batter
okay.
for the bottom and then half for the top.
All right, so Over the Hill Orchards.
Yeah,
okay.
Over the Hill Orchards in Lumsden.
Okay.
Fantastic company. I mean, really terrific, all organic. Great, so go ahead and look at the color. That doesn't have any food coloring in it.
Oh, wow, really? So this is all...
This is the real deal. So now we're gonna take the dough and we're just gonna dopple it all over the top like that.
Looking pretty good.
Terrific. So that's gonna go in the oven now at 350.
All right.
For, let's see here, about 30 minutes. And then we'll put on a nice little glaze. In the meantime, this looks fantastic.
All right, well, let's get it into the oven then.
Yeah, and then when we come back, I'm gonna show you how to make a spritz cookie.
Oh.
So now we've got this spritz cookie dough. This is a very soft cookie dough because it has to go into a gun like this, which is a spritzer.
Mm-hmm.
Now it can take a few little, there we go. And then you can just take a few little sprinkles and you can put sprinkles here too.
Mm-hmm.
And you just sprinkle the top. And it just already looks like Christmas.
Oh, yeah.
Now, when these things, you look at this and you say, yeah, but there's all kinds of space between the mm-hmm. balls here. When it bakes, it puffs up and they all fuse together.
Nice. So okay. So it's going to be primarily decorated then. So that's
already good.
Absolutely.
And if you want, you can do it plain and then drizzle over a little bit of glaze.
Mm. Okay, so CJ, so we're here. Everything is cooling here for us. So we're just going to have a convo and talk. So you started off, you're an import into this province.
Yeah.
So how'd you get started in the cooking industry as an author, an expert? How'd you get started?
I know, it's crazy. I can't believe how good this province has been for me. I'm totally grateful.
Okay.
Nobody was really writing about what was going on mm-hmm. in the city with regard to food.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm.
And that's kind of how it started. I started mm-hmm. a newsletter called Savor Life.
Mm-hmm.
And it was funny, that one little newsletter spun me off mm-hmm. into radio. Then it spun me off into CTV, where I've now got my cooking show, now in its 9th season.
Wow.
And then the cookbook evolved out of the TV show.
What's the book called?
It's called Taste, Seasonal Dishes from a Prairie Table.
Okay.
And it's is a professionally bound a cookbook available through Chapters. Mm-hmm. You can get it on Amazon. Mm-hmm. It's all over the place. It's an mm-hmm. award-winning book. And
there you go.
You know, kind of everything's kind of evolved out of there.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I'm just grateful for that. I'm grateful for all the...
Well, I can hear the passion. You know, I can hear that you really enjoy what you do.
So I think you need to come on my show. Oh. Seeing as you had me.
Okay.
You got to come on mine.
Okay. No ugly sweaters, though. No ugly sweaters.
No ugly sweaters.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
All right.
You can look as hot as you want.
Okay. Thanks. Okay.
Just keep your shirt on.
All right. Okay. Absolutely. So you heard it here first.
Yeah.
I'm going to go on CJ's show at some point. You're going to get me on there making
some
breakfast tacos.
We'll get you this season.
Okay. Outstanding. That's even better.
Yeah.
All right, so it looks like everything's kind of cooled down. Mm-hmm. We're gonna come back and it's gonna be some taste testing now. All right, so we have our cookies made.
Mm-hmm.
Our cherry cooking bars are out.
Yep.
Let's get a drizzle on there and let's,
exactly.
It's time to taste a little bit here.
This is a very simple glaze, okay. Cup and a half of icing sugar, little bit, quarter teaspoon maybe of vanilla.
Okay.
And then milk just so that you get this beautiful consistency.
Mm-hmm.
Almost like thicker than buttermilk, but doesn't that look gorgeous?
Oh yeah.
And so just take your whisk like this and just drizzle it on. You just keep grabbing it and just...
Absolutely.
Okay, so we got it like this. We've also got a little bit left here. And so we've got our lovely cookies. Some of them are decorated, but you can take a glaze like this and just put it on the top of the cookie.
Ah, there we go.
And there you go. Why don't you try that one? Whoops. And see what you think of that. Mmm. Whoa.
Really good. Yep.
Just a really nice standard sugar cookie, right? One of the things that I like to do is just change up the sugar cookie, and I like to put in maybe a quarter of a teaspoon of nutmeg, and that works really well in there too.
Nutmeg on the sugar cookie, that's the first time I've heard that. That's awesome.
Yeah. No, I actually grew up with sugar cookies that had nutmeg in them. So, here we go. Now, these are bars. You can serve it. To me, a kuchen, you can actually serve as a bigger piece for a dessert.
Okay.
Or you can cut it into smaller pieces. And like this thing, you could probably get quite a few bars out of. A bar is that smaller piece, just like that. Cut them into sort of 1-inch by 2-inch pieces, right? So then when you're making your cookie tray, you've got your sugar cookies, you've got your kuchen here, and then another very pretty festive cookie, also from your cookbook, are these peppermint meringues.
Oh yeah.
You see? And those are pretty, they hold really well.
They're really light.
They're very light, and those are gluten-free. So for people who, you know, why don't you try that one?
All right. You gonna hop in here as well?
Okay, I'll hop in there too.
All right. Great.
Terrific. Great. Terrific little cake. I think we could have put even more cherries on there. Okay. Really torqued it out.
Yeah. Really good. Really good.
This is terrific. Thank you for having me on.
It's been great. You know, we always try to make it a little festive, Christmas show, and this is something obviously people can do at home.
It is.
And with family, like we spoke about earlier.
I think that's really important, you know, getting family around, gathering around.
Get everybody in the kitchen, you know, hey, let's have some time together and do something.
Well, I brought in a Christmas present for you, because we're in the Christmas season.
Ah.
And I brought you in a copy of my cookbook.
Oh.
For you to have.
You know what? Since we're doing that, I've got a copy of my cookbook for you as
well. That's terrific. I'm excited. I love this book. It's been around a long time. I grew up with that book. So.
Well, that's, you know what? We hear a lot of that. And every now and then, new recipes do go in here. And so this is the new cookbook.
Okay.
All right. So here we go.
Well, you get to do that. This is all about Saskatchewan.
Oh, outstanding.
And lots of savory recipes in there, including that steak recipe that I really like.
The steak recipe's in here?
It's in there.
I already know what I'm making. Okay. I already know what I'm making.
Terrific.
Okay. Awesome. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Well, that was food fun. If you'd like the recipes, check out our website. Thanks to our sponsors from Scratch Kitchen, Better Homes and Gardens Real Estate Prairie View, and a big thanks to our special guest, CJ Katz. I'm Matt Dominguez, and we'll see you next time.